Okay, Assalamualaikum and good afternoon to Encik Amar and all our fellow friends. Today we are going to present regarding our topic, which is wind power system. So here are all our group members.
Hi, my name is Mas Nasabila binti Matno.
I'm Ali Shira.
My name is Nushyaza Shafika binti Zulhamri.
I'm Sarah Hanun.
And I am Mam.
Okay, hope you guys enjoy watching our video. Thank you.
Thank you.
I don't understand.
Okay, since you are here, do you prepare the slides that I told you to prepare last night?
Oh yeah.
What kind of slide? I forgot to tell you guys that actually some of my friends texted me saying that the topics that are going to come out in our final exam, since that subject is just around the corner, so I guess our subject this afternoon could be that topic. Is it okay? Or do you want to change to
another subject? What kind of subject?
It's electrical technology subject.
Yep. Oh my god, Encik Amar?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so the topics given by my friends was wind power. So I think it's better if we just proceed to that, since you got the slides, isn't it?
Yeah. Let me tell you about the story about this wind energy. Okay, story. The first windmill used for the production of the electric power was built in Scotland in July 1887 by Professor James Blake of Anderson College.
It's been so long.
Yep.
So long.
At the Glasgow. Okay. Blake's 10 meters and 33 feet high closed cell wind turbine was installed in the garden of his holiday cottage at Merrick in Kincardineshire. Accumulators developed by the Frenchman Camille
Alphonse
Frog to power the lighting in cottage.
So it's such a great system.
Yeah.
What about the definition?
Okay, well, for the definition is use of airflow through wind turbine mechanically power generators for the electric power. Wind power as an alternative to burning fossil fuels is plentiful, renewable, widely distributed, clean, produce no greenhouse gas emission during operation, consumes no water, and use little land.
I will be discussing about the two types of the wind power. There are horizontal axis wind power and vertical axis wind turbines power. Okay, that was a horizontal has a similar design to a windmill. It has blades that look like a propeller that spin on the horizontal axis.
Is this the blade?
Yes.
Oh. Where did you get this picture?
I got from internet. We'll tell you more about that picture.
Yeah, it's good you put this picture here so that we could see how does it actually looks like, so that we don't feel like blur, is it?
Yes. We can see all that. Okay, next. Horizontal axis wind turbines have the main rotor shaft and electrical generator at the top of a tower, and they must be pointed into the wind. Small turbines are pointed by a simple wind vane placed square with the rotor blades, while large turbines generally use a wind sensor coupled with a servo motor to turn the turbine in the wind. Most large turbines have a gearbox, which turns the slow rotation of the rotor in a faster rotation that is more suitable to drive an electrical generator. So, the turbine is usually pointed upwind of the tower. Wind turbine blades are made stiff to prevent the blades from being pushed into the tower by high winds. Additionally, in high resistance. Okay. So, next slide, I will tell you about the vertical wind power. So, the vertical axis is the main advantage of this arrangement, in the wind turbine does not need to be pointed in the wind. So this is an advantage of such where the wind direction is highly variable or has turbulence wind. Wow, that was the picture.
Picture also different.
Yeah, the picture was different.
Horizontal.
Yeah.
Basically, the shape is different than the first one.
Yeah. Ah. So, the wind speed is lower at a lower altitude, so less wind energy is available for a given size turbine. Issues of vibration, including noise and bearing wear, which may increase the maintenance or shorten its service life. When turbine is mounted on the rooftop, the building generally redirects wind over the roof, and this can double one speed and the turbine. So that's all summarized of the types of vertical and horizontal
exists. Yeah, how about the operation? Okay, my friends told me that the operation is such a the most crucial part. So this is the one that we need to memorize.
Yeah, so scary.
Mm.
Yeah. It's such scary things.
Yes.
Okay, here I put a picture so that you can see. This is the parts in the wind turbine. It consists of rotor diameter, gearbox, generator, rotor blade, and gearbox. This is for horizontal axis wind turbines, and this is vertical axis wind turbine.
Yeah.
Okay, I jot down some notes.
Okay, that okay. I can photocopy.
Yes, of course, but you still have to pay attention.
Yes.
Okay, wind turbine, it actually operates only using a small simple principle. Okay, we just have to know that basically wind power or wind turbine, it uses wind, isn't it?
Yes.
So energy in the wind would turn two or three propeller like blades around the rotor. So basically a rotor is connected to the main shaft, and this will spin a generator to create electricity. That is why the it can generate electricity.
Oh.
Okay. Okay. Instead of fan, like wind turbine, it spin around the opposite like fan. Meaning that if fans would spinning clockwise, but it's a different thing for wind power or wind turbine, it would go opposite way. Okay, wind turbines can create more electricity because rotor diameter is connected to the generator. So the wind through the blades which spin the shaft that is connected to the generator, and this one will cause electricity. Sarah has stated that there are two types of wind
power.
Turbine, right?
Yeah,
so the principle are almost the same. The different thing is just the rotation of the blade. If the horizontal, it will go horizontal. If the blade is vertical, it will go vertical. But then the principle is just the same.
Right, this wind turbine. Advantage of wind power for horizontal is the turn tower base allows to access to stronger wind inside the wind shear. In some wind shear site, every 10 meters up, the wind speed can increase by 20%.
20%?
Yes, and the power output by 34%.
It's a bigger.
Yes. High efficiency, since the blade always move perpendicularly to the wind, receiving power through the whole rotation. For vertical axis wind turbine, no yaw mechanism is needed.
No yaw at all?
Yes. A vertical axis wind turbine can be located nearing the ground, making it easier to maintain the moving part. Vertical axis wind turbine have lower wind startup speed than the horizontal. Vertical axis may be built at location where taller structure are from high wind. Okay, this is the disadvantage of wind power. Just now I just explained about advantage, right? Now I want to explain about disadvantage. Yes, they also have advantage and disadvantage. Disadvantage of horizontal axis, massive tower construction is required to support the heavy blade, gearbox, and generator.
Required to support?
Heavy blade, and gearbox, and generator.
Oh, so it may cause a lot of...
Yes, it may cause.
High cost.
Yes. Components of a horizontal axis wind turbine, gearbox, rotor shaft, and brake assembly being lifted into position.
Horizontal axis also require an additional gear control mechanism to turn the blade toward the wind. It generally require a braking or yawing device in high wind to stop the turbine from spinning and destroying or damaging itself. For vertical, most vertical axes have a average decrease efficiency from a common horizontal, mainly because of the additional drag that they have has.
So there are a few examples of several countries that implement wind power. The first one is China. China has the largest wind market access of any country according to the WWEA. By last June, China had around 67.7 gigawatt of wind capacity for peak installation. Yesin said this number is likely closer to 80 now. Large scale wind power development began less than 10 years ago here. Okay, the second one is United States of America. Like usually, looking at the world wind energy association rankings, the United States comes just behind China for total wind power capacity. Currently, the United States has close to 60 gigawatt, so much more than China lah. However, the total number of installment per capita in the United States isn't impressive. The third one is Germany. Germany leads the European wind market with more than 30 gigawatts, having the United States surpassed 100 gigawatts of installed wind energy at all. Despite its coal lobby, the country remains committed to renewable energy. Even parties on the fence about renewable energy will run enormous political risk by coming out in position. And last but not least, India. Wow. India was one of the first developing countries to introduce large-scale wind power. Population and high industrial growth rate have created increasing energy.
Can we conclude our discussion?
Okay, after the completion of the assignment, we managed to know how does only a wind power could generate electricity yet with the benefit it offers that will give no pollution to the earth. Now how could the humankind like us, animals, or to the surrounding and environment itself make it become as one of the energy that commonly used by many countries? As wind power systems are connected to a utility power grid or even combined with a photovoltaic system makes it come with other additional benefits, which could generate electricity by turning on the light on the street, pumping water, grinding grains, and charging batteries has shown us that this system meet the need of current electrical technology.
So much benefit to us actually. Yes. I think let's stop here.
I'll go back home.
Yeah.
Really
sleeping. Time right now. Oh my.